of success for LA here tonight.
Teams are downsizing, they're going big at times, and you've got to have...
The Hornets get the inbound in here. Kaminsky's looking for position in the paint. Walker against Brewer. Nice inside pass. ...11 seconds remaining on the 24. Goes to the left hand. And LA's called for the foul. Their third team foul. And here's another look at it. And it's on to the free throw line for a couple of freebies. Oops, missed the first one. Misses a pair of free throws. Nice relentless attitude. Gets the offensive board and puts it back up and in.
That's unfundamental right there. You've got to make sure you block out and...
Oh, bad decision. Adjust the shot. Oh, nice block. Goes to the pull-up. That's a three-pointer. Won't go from outside the arc. Careless ball handling. Off the dribble and to the rim. No go off the backboard.
Guy goes up in the paint. You have to contest it and make them miss.
It's a loose ball. Lopez misses at the rim.
Hey, you're in a close game. You better guard like your life depended on it. And they did right there, contesting that shot.
Just on the shot, gets it to go. No foul, though.
When you're playing from ahead, you never take possessions off. Get the rebound, secure it, and then don't take your foot off the gas pedal. Keep pushing it at him and score in transition.
Kid Gilchrist unable to flip it in.
Hey, that's good offense right there. But if they don't convert those easy shots, their lead will evaporate.
Ingram to Lopez, looking to dominate down low. With no room, soft touch, gets the roll. He's averaging 15 points per game this season.
That's just tremendous defensive effort. You did all you could to prevent the make. Unfortunately, he stuck it.
What a rejection.
Oh, that's a great block right there. Combination of timing, athleticism, and want. Tremendous shot block.
Batum. To the rim. Kid Gilchrist misses another one.
Tremendous job making it difficult to get to the basket.
Ingram's looking to set up in the paint. Still plenty of time. 12 seconds on the shot clock.
West cutter.
Not a lot of time for a shot opportunity. Oh, nice pull-up jumper. The whistle and a foul called against Carter Williams. That's his first, and he'll head to the line. Misses the first. So he goes 1 for 2 from the line after hitting the second. Walker's looking for the screen to get himself open. Oh, the quick release. Kaminsky's first shot off the mark. Gets in the paint. Look at him take it all the way. Coast to coast for the layup at the other end.
You got to get your guys down the floor in transition quicker than they can get back. If you can rebound it and then get it up the floor, you're going to have number.
The ball stolen. For the layup, Walker the rebound. Weaves his way to the... the basket. Kaminsky's bank shot just off the mark.
Driving the ball into the paint is the most...
Oh, no! He just crushed the defender with the slam.
Now that's how you finish strong at the rim. That was worth the price of admission right there.
Walker passes it right back. He curls, adjusting on the shot. It's good. And one. And Kemba Walker will go to the line with seconds to go here in the first. Able to convert the free throw, and he completes the three-point play. At the buzzer. First quarter complete. The Lakers down by three. We'll be right back with more NBA basketball here on ESPN after the break. So first quarter complete, about to begin quarter number two. A little bit of a feeling out process.
Well, you're right, Mike. You know, sometimes you don't get a real good grasp on how the game's going to go, but it was well played by both teams. Close competitive game.
Ball comes loose. Here's a steal. Oh, a ferocious dunk.
Great timing. Great elevation. Awesome dunk.
The screen is set. Can't hold on to the ball. Gets to the rim. Gets to two. Lucky roll.
Easy baskets are critical over the course of a long game. Here in the first half, establishing a tone that we're going to get to the basket in transition versus settle for jump shots.
Oh, excellent screen to Dang from downtown. That three-pointer off the mark. Luol Deng's 0-for-2 from long range.
Even great shooters are distracted by a great closeout and a hard contest.
Terrific feed. He gets it to go. Excellent teamwork. Gets past him with the dribble. Just won't go for a point-blank range.
Hey, you got to finish strong on those shots. You're right at the basket. You got to put the ball in the hole.
Defense has to switch. Nance fires away. Good finish inside.
When everybody is involved in touching the ball, like what's happening here in the first half, and you've got your assist total up, then you're going to create also a defensive intensity at the other end of the floor. And that's exactly what has happened here in the first half.
Nance, bank shot, no good.
You can't hope people miss. You've got to make them miss in this league. Contesting those shots makes other teams miss.
Oh, he got hit, and they call it. Draws the foul, called against Nance. And Marvin Williams will go to the line. And he connects on the first free throw. Boy, misses the second free throw. He goes 1-for-2. Unable to back it in. Comes down with the offensive board and follows it up. Quick bucket there.
Come on. You're better than that. You can block out and get a free throw rebound. You don't give up second chance opportunities from a free throw line situation.
And there's a timeout call. And the Charlotte Hornets make a substitution. Goes to the crossover. Can't get it to go from close range. The comeback kid has been able to accomplish some impressive feats this season.
especially when you consider the pressure that's being put on today's rookies. These young men constantly being asked to deliver and perform amid all this attention and off the court demands as well.
The scrutiny has never been more challenging for a young player in the NBA. The advent of the social media world puts them under the microscope 24 hours a day. No misstep is tolerated. That can be helpful in some avenues, but also the pressure to be perfect is unrelenting.
Nope, first free throw won't go. Good bounce back, hitting the second free throw. He's 1 for 2. To Zeller. Oh, quick move, gets inside. He got a piece of it. 3.5 gone by in the second. LA's down by 1. There's the pick. We're down to 9 seconds on the shot clock. They've got to get this off in a hurry. Part of Williams' shot blocked.
This is an absolute joke, the way both of these teams are turning the ball over. It's hard to fathom how they let this game get so out of hand.
The Lakers get to inbound. To Randall. Ball loose again. Oh, he gets the steal. Good setup with the entry pass. Howard's using the screen, looking to get free. Feeds it right back. Not a lot of time for a shot here. Pass deflected, but they hold on. In and out. That went halfway down.
You're only in control of your effort and your discipline. Here, a very disciplined defensive possession, great intensity, forcing the great shooter to take a difficult off-balance shot and force the miss.
Defense nearly grabbed it. Lopez for 2. He rattles it in.
When you play that good a defense and you contest the two-point J, you expect a good result there. The offense was just superior. The concentration and the follow-through, he stuck his shot.
Good solid entry pass. Fires away for 2. Gets it to go. Excellent teamwork. And Kentavious Caldwell-Pope will get to inbound. Into the paint. Ball for 2. Puts it up. Converts on the inside.
The pull-up off the dribble is the most indefensible shot in basketball. Here, he knocks it in a tight contest.
I got ball.
This kid is dealing with tremendous pressure. All young players have it, but the spotlight so intense for this young man.
Yeah, very similar to what Lonzo Ball's going through. Obviously, because of his great performance at UCLA, him being drafted by his hometown Lakers, his father's mouth that runs constantly, 24/7, all of those things have added up to having extreme pressure as well.
Ball comes loose. It's a turnover off the deflected pass. To the basket, flips it up, and straight down the middle.
How do you exploit a team best in transition? You attack the rim. You give yourself a chance to get to the free throw line. That's a mentality that will carry over to the second half.
Shot no good. Down to a half minute remaining in the first half. The Lakers up by 1. Zeller scores the basket following that perfect entry pass.
Number
Randle. Oh, he loses it. Wide open for three. To the rim. Nice work on the adjustment and banks it home. Final seconds. Ball's three-pointer off the mark. That's it for the first half. The Lakers down by three. Plenty more to come on ESPN on EA Sports right after halftime.
We're moments away from the third quarter. Mike and Jeff are ready to call the second half action.
The Hornets get the inbound. Quick decision and gets rid of it. Kaminsky finding all the room. He shoots. Perfect entry pass. Oh, nice rebound by Kaminsky.
That's become a familiar sight, watching him grab rebound after rebound. He's definitely putting in the work.
The defense doesn't react. They give up the easy basket after the offensive board. And Los Angeles calls yet another timeout. That didn't take long.
I am absolutely on the edge of my seat during this game. The back and forth, the lead changes, every possession, so important to the outcome of the game.
That shot won't go.
Hey, when you're going up against the great shooters in this league, you need to combat that with tenacity and passion. Tremendous defensive possession, forcing the miss against one of the great shooters in our league.
The comeback kid has a tight inner circle. His friends are close friends, including Nick Howard, in the EuroLeague, still hoping to get to the NBA. Hey, Jeff, you think the success of the comeback kid can improve Nick's chances of making it into the pros?
Yes, I think, you know, when you have one hype brother in the NBA and you see how well he's done, you might be willing to take more of a chance on the other hype brother, even though maybe he's not quite as gifted. Why not have Nick Howard on an NBA roster? If you're good enough for the EuroLeague, you can make that jump. I think it does help.
It's good. 6-point lead for Charlotte.
You need guys who can beat their man off the dribble and finish at the basket.
Pass is broken up, stolen by Howard. Pass to the corner. To Howard. Sweet dish. Goes to the reverse. Lays it up and in. Terrific pass from Dwight Howard.
That's just a nice layup right there.
Back on offense, they need to get something going. Puts it up from downtown. Rebound snatched by Kaminsky.
This is what I wanted right here. This is it.
Pass to the corner. Inside. Puts it in. And they extend the lead to double figures. Good switching on defense. Curling in. A ferocious slam.
Are you kidding me? You're not going to help? This guy has a matchup nightmare right now.
It'll count if it goes. Won't go. And they can't extend the lead into double figures. Three quarters complete. The home team has heard it from the crowd all night long. Despite the poor performance, they still have a shot here.
They do. And right now, if you're a fan, quit booing, stand up, and try to energize your team. Yeah, anybody can pile on, but do your job so the team can do theirs.
Ball knocked loose. There's a steal.
One of the keys to winning in this league is not beating yourself. Both teams seem determined to beat themselves rather than their opponent.
To Howard. Screen set nicely.
moves around the defender, goes to the goal. It's good. A two-pointer. He's shooting 66% from the field.
Nice layup off the drive to get the easy basket.
To Randall. Randall forcing against a smothering defense. Caught him on the reach-in. Coach going to make some changes and switch up the matchups. And Nicola Batum will get the in.
All right, let's do this.
Substitutions. In the paint. Oh, he knocks it down.
You're not going to see a better possession in the NBA from both sides of the ball. Good defense, good offense. Good offense won out that time.
Ball knocked out of his hands. Oh, and he throws it away. Don't forget to join us again Sunday as the Lakers head back home for a short two-game homestand. Williams for two, lets it go. Can't connect from close range.
It's all about making your teammates better. And the way you make them better is to give up a good shot to try to create a great shot.
There's a foul. It's called against the Lakers. Second team foul. Here's a look at what's in store with today's NBA matchup. The Hornets get the inbound in here. To Zeller. At the rim. Nice pass inside to the basket.
You can tell both of these teams are completely unselfish with the basketball. Look at the assist total, and you can tell that both teams have learned very well that sharing is the true joy in this game.
To Williams. Here's the screen. What an ankle breaker there. Banks it home.
This speed is hard to guard. Speed kills. Beats his man off the dribble and then finishes right at the basket.
To the rim. That's good. A two-pointer.
You're not going to see it much better than that from an offensive finishing point of view against quality NBA defense.
Oh, excellent screen. Quick move to get inside. Gets it down low. Swats that away. Pretty little pass. Knocks it down. 4-point game. To the basket, just rolls in off the rim.
Hey, kids at home, you need to study this man's body control and poise as he finished that shot in the paint.
Thrown away! Tremendous denial on that shot. Entry pass gets it inside. Gets to the rim. Ooh, misses the inside shot.
Hey, you want to win in this game? You got to protect the paint in the last 2 minutes of a close game.
For two, misses at the rim, puts it up, nails it.
Pound the offensive board, get extra possession. Great job in the pursuit of the basketball and then finishing at the rim.
To Williams. Gets into the paint, to the rim. Oh, sinks the two-pointer.
You're not winning late in a close game playing that type of defense, allowing the ball to go in a direct line drive right at the basket.
Fires away for two. Not that time. To Williams. Oh, yeah,
dumps it off beautifully. Through the basket, unable to flip it in.
Another good offensive possession. Unfortunately, they're just not finishing with the strength and conviction that's necessary.
Decides to pass. Misses the shot.
This guy's a great shooter. They were on him like Velcro and forced the miss. Good defense.
Let's it go. That one halfway down before popping out.
Some might question that shot right there. I like that shot. You have a great player who's a great shooter. I like the creativity. He just missed it.
Heading down the final stretch. It's crunch time. Now on the shot clock. Here's the pick. Oh, pretty move into the paint. Oh, rejected!
Oh, wow! Great timing on that block!
Time running out here in the fourth. There's a timeout.
The strategy is simple right now. You come out of the timeout, you execute, you get a score. And then you have to trust your defense. No unnecessary fouls.
Puts it in. 4-point game.
Look, that's what he's known for right there. The ability to contort his body and score the ball while defended well.
Oh, in and out.
Hey, that's a tough shot, but I'd rather have a good player taking a bad shot than a bad player taking a good shot.
Zeller the rebound. 4-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Passes it back to him. The shot is blocked.
Oh, my. What a block.
To Brewer. Puts it up for three. Unable to convert from the three-point line. In and out. And that will do it. The final score is 76-72. For Jeff Van Gundy and our entire EA Sports crew, this is Mike Breen saying good night.